let us know about a new topic today, that is Cyclopean Eye. In this topic, we will be covering details about introduction to Cyclopean Eye, about crossed diplopia and uncrossed diplopia. If you like our videos, please subscribe us and click the bell icon to get our all tutorials. Subscribe to Smart Optometry. Introduction. We see with two eyes, but we don't see the object double, so binocular vision can be represented by a single eye. The cyclopean eye is an imaginary eye situated midway between the two eyes. Here alongside, in the diagram, you can see the cyclopean eye. Using the cyclopean eye, crossed and uncrossed diplopia or disparity can be explored. The principle of cyclopean eye can be applied to patients with strabismus, that is those who have misalignment of eyes. Patients with strabismus are usually classified according to the direction of the eye turn. Two common types of strabismus are patients with an esotropia with their eyes turned in and patients with exotropia their eyes turned out. Patients with an exotropia will have crossed diplopia while patients with an esotropia will have uncrossed diplopia. Among the two diagrams alongside, in the first diagram you can see the esotropic eye where the image of the target is seen on the same side as that of the misaligned eye, that is the right eye target is seen on the right side. This is called uncrossed diplopia. In the second diagram, you can see the exotropic eye where the image of the target is seen on the other side as compared to the misaligned eye, that is the right eye target is seen on the left side. This is called crossed diplopia. For an object closer than the fixation point, cross diplopia occurs as the image of the object falls on temporal retina of both eyes. In the diagram alongside, you can see that the object focused is closer than the fixation point and so we get cross diplopia. This is termed cross diplopia because the image in the left eye is seen on the right side and vice versa. Uncrossed diplopia. For an object located further than the fixation point, the image of the object falls on the nasal retina of both eyes, producing uncrossed diplopia. In the diagram alongside, you can see that the object is found to be further away than the fixation point, thus giving rise to uncrossed diplopia. This is termed uncrossed diplopia because the image in the left eye is seen on the left side.